presentation at this moment is that if the committee is predisposed to objecting to all the rules set forth by the commission, it would be in the best service of the state to do that now rather than in October, so that whatever happens next would start sooner rather than later. Secondly, the board, as the members of...
Commission.
The commission. As the members of Elkhart know, had proposed that they were willing to withdraw standards having to do with distance prior to our postponement of any decision. And that Mr. Adler, in anticipation of Elkhart making a decision on these rules, had also made a list of questions that Mr. Adler thought needed to be answered before we voted to approve or not approve the rules, and had submitted these to the board for the board's review and for suggested modifications to the questions posed. And Mr. Adler, did you get a response from the board on those?
Yeah, the board responded about the changes that it was willing to make if the committee wanted them to make the changes, essentially.
Does the committee understand that those are over and above the board statement that it would remove the distance standards if the committee...
Those were separate from that statement.
They're separate from...
Do we have that in writing? Do we have those? I saw it online. Do we have it in writing? I did not bring my full packet of rules.
Do you have to have?
We don't have multiple copies, probably. I don't know. Yeah. It's, it has been sent to you before.
Right. I have it. I just don't have it with me.
I did email them. I mean, we can resend them, or we can print them out if you need them today.
I don't need them today.
So it's the chair has brought this up because if this Elkhart is going to object to all the rules, the entire package is being it's going to object to the entire package for whatever reasons it might. It would be better to do that sooner rather than later. And I'm not going to ask for a straw poll, but then on the other hand, I'd like to, if this group knew what it was likely to do, it would help us to do our job in a time frame that was most helpful to all involved, and not to put off a decision until October, which would then, should we object, cause a greater hardship or scrambling or whatever. And I don't know, I put this out for discussion to members of Elkhart for that reason. And if anybody had any comment on what they thought would be most in the best interests, this would be the time to speak up. Senator Lawrence.
So I'm not ready to vote today.
The chair would not entertain it.
Did not.
The public would need to.
I did not do a thorough review of all the information that we have, which I would do. But I do carry the sense that the sound standards that were put out, 39 dBO, that appeared to me to be arbitrary in its the way it was established. So that's a concern, and I don't know how I'm going to deal with that.
Anyone else? Representative Schoen.
I appreciate you bringing it forward. I think I agree. I actually feel like we have a leadership act sooner anyway. I mean, I know it was around people's travel schedules, but I think getting a sense of how we're going to move forward. So are you proposing to put it on the agenda for Next time, what are you proposing?
We don't have much on the agenda next time, do we?
We don't.
The fur bearing, we have, oh, I shouldn't have said that.
Oh, sorry, how many do we have?
I'm not sure yet. We have like four.
We have Department of Labor.
And we have SOS.
Opioids.
Modernization.
Mr. Chair, if you refresh my memory as to why we postponed this such a long time.
Some of this is opinion. One was, the board had offered to, it suggested it might remove the distance standards. Senator Benning thought more time would be appropriate and that the entire committee would be assembled in October, whereas over the summer, there might be members of Elkhart missing. And when we made the motion to extend, there were, I think, some committee members that said, oh, removing the distance standard, that's, of course. And, but the rest of it has flaws, and there are others that might believe that, yes, remove the distance standard, it has the rest. We haven't. So that's where we are. There've been some back and forth, I understand, with the board, which has suggested that it doesn't plan to make any changes between now and October. It's gonna stand pat until then. Maybe the board would have some, would offer some changes sooner. Maybe the questions that Mr. Adler has asked, but the board has, once again, responded to in some detail or?
They responded to them, they proposed language, but these, what I'm addressing are more controversial issues. They're notched down from that. It's not about changing the decibel standards. It's not about moving the setback. It's
more technical.
More technical. It's somewhat more technical. I mean, they do have substantive impact. I didn't re-review them this morning. I should have, but I don't have.
Is it fair to say that they're the sort of routine gray areas that you bring to us meeting after meeting?
I believe so.
Usually come to an agreement with the proposers of the rule that, yes, the areas are gray and the solutions.
In general, yes.
In general, yes. So I'm trying to characterize where Elkhart is today and what the committee would feel is the most responsible and timely action we should take. I'm inclined to agree with Senator Lyons' assessment. And if the committee would say we're ready to vote on these rules, rather than wait until October, then Mr. Chair would schedule such a vote. And I don't want to not hear the surprise or the commission, but to let them know that some of this committee is antsy to get ahead with our work and to come to resolution, whatever it might be. Representative.
Okay, so this is my opinion. This is a major decision that has to be made. And I understand your position in that it would be better if we worked on it sooner than later. But I also feel that we are an 8-member committee. And I really feel that if we're going to make a decision, whether it passes or whether it fails, that there should be 8 people here. And that, and I'm, this is strictly because of me, okay? I'll be here next, at the next meeting, the 13th. Then I will not be back. The earliest I would be able to attend is the last meeting in September. And that's, as I said before, I come in the day before on a red eye from the West Coast. So getting here that morning is so that the first meeting in October, I mean, I can make it. If you feel like you want to do it, I will be here for that. But that, you know, Joe's not going to be here next week, the next meeting, and then I'll be missing two meetings in September.
And that was the reason that we postponed it in the first place.
And I really feel that, you know, regardless of whether it passes or it fails, how we feel about it now or how we feel about it in, let's say the end of September would be, you know, I could commit to coming that day, given that the plane actually arrives, that we all should be here for that decision.
Excuse me?
I think we had talked about this earlier, and I think we should just adhere to what we had said. If there's some, is there a pressing need to vote on the rule before, I mean, have we heard from the board, the commission? They can't function without this rule.
All right. Aaron, remind us of the status of what we're functioning on.
So.
And today, it would be altered should rule be approved or would be in limbo should the rule not be approved.
So, pursuant to legislative direction, the board adopted the temporary rule on sound levels from regeneration. That is in effect, and its period of being in effect was extended because this committee extended the deadline for the board to commission to adopt a permanent rule. And so.
At the commission's request?
Yes, well.
We can't extend it without their request.
The commission, yes, that's true. The commission was responding to this committee's desire for more time to extend the rule, too. So it was a mutual. Mutual requests were made. So because there is a temporary rule in effect, that probably mitigates when there is a pressing need. I would note that any applications that are filed under the temporary rule will be under the standards in that rule as opposed to the standards that are proposed. The proposed standards are lower. Are lower decibel levels. I mean, I don't believe, if I recall correctly, there is no setback in the temporary rule, but I'm getting this from. So it will affect, if there are wind cases that are filed between that, while the LCAR is considering permanent rule, it will affect the rules, the standards that actually apply, but there will be standards in place.
And those standards will be less strict or prohibitive than what has been proposed rule.
They can be characterized that way.
It could be characterized that way.
Given that they are certainly, the decibel levels are higher. At least the 45 dBA is higher than the 42. And I don't believe there's a setback.
So the longer they go, the
got that.
More. So, I don't know what that's where we are at, and I would ask the committee by the next meeting to let us know if that's where you think we ought to be, or whether we should act sooner rather than later. I would welcome the board to communicate with us what it thinks at this time is in the best interest of all involved. Give us some sort of communication by my next meeting. I would certainly, if you know, if I were gone for a wedding or whatever, and if not here, Elkhart thought it was the proper thing to do, act sooner rather than later, I'd make my decision next. No, we're all gone. It's not needed. Representative Myers, that would be disrespectful to those who can't be here if we ought to act sooner rather than later. And if we ought to, the next meeting, let's come to a decision on that. And give the board an opportunity to send us any signal they want to send us. Purpose of bringing this up as far as the chair's concerned is, that's where we're at, if anybody would like to ask it. Add anything, this would be the time. If not, we're done for the day. Representative Chestnut Tangerman.
So you'd ask for an indication of our, and I would tend to agree with what Senator Clement said about the supporting retraction of the setback and having concerns about how the deep levels are established. I guess as far as the voting on full committee or not, because it's an important vote, I like the idea of all of us being here, and I don't see it that, I don't see attendance as being related to swinging the vote one way or another. Seems to me to be a
clear. Courtesy one always tries to do for colleagues, if possible.
So I don't have, much as I'd like to see us deal with it, I don't have an objection to postponing it for that reason. I have been a little concerned about postponing the fur-bearing rule because it seemed to me to be...
Because of the...
Yeah.
That's going to be the first item on the agenda.
That's next time, the 17th, we have it.
Anyone else? Just motion to adjourn, is it? Mr. Rattle?
Before you move to adjourn, I have something to mention to the committee on a totally different topic. So the Secretary of State has been wanting to meet with the committee, and I believe has asked to be on the agenda for the 17th. They're interested in what they're calling a modernization of the rulemaking process. And so they're hoping to hear from LCAR any views that the members may have. And I just wanted to make sure that you were aware that they were doing that and that they are asked to be on the agenda for next meeting.
So are they expecting us to give input on the 17th? Are they coming in to do a presentation that we can then consider and think about?
I believe that they are coming to do a presentation, is my understanding. They are probably hoping for input. If you would like us to communicate to them that you might want to give input after you have time to hear the presentation, thank you, can certainly communicate.
Scheduling them for the last item on the agenda for the next meeting, so they can do that. They're not going to hang around for a long time and make a decision.
It might be good if they have anything in advance on their presentation for us to receive.
But could we, Amy has just asked about maybe extending the meeting for perhaps a half an hour, at least longer.
I'm wondering if we need to do
I can't do it on the 17th.
Do that on the
would 17th. Be nice to do it, but I can't do it the 17th, but that's a good idea.
Oh. Okay.
Go for you.
I have another appointment right after. So with that, I'll move that we adjourn.
Thank you, Representative. Move that we adjourn. Can we say that?
Aye.
Can I say that? Thank you all for your taking it.